Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Glory Tabernacle Prayer Line, together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry. We are now in the portion of sharing the word, and before I call on Bishop Mel, let's open up in prayer.
Heavenly Father, we welcome your Holy Spirit's presence and anointing on this prayer line live. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to anoint Bishop Mel as he brings forth the word, Lord God. Lord, use him as your vessel of honor tonight. And Lord, encourage your people through the word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. May we call Bishop Mel?
Hallelujah. Good evening, everyone. This is Bishop Mel. Thank you for coming to the prayer line live. Today you will hear the word of God through your servant. The title of the message tonight is Spending Time with God Offers Eternal Benefits. Spending time with God offers eternal benefits. The text tonight came from the book of Matthew, chapter 14, verse 23. Matthew, chapter 14, verse 23. Let me just open up in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for coming to the prayer line together with your people, O God. Lord, we thank you for the word, O God, that you give, that you impress upon my heart tonight, that will give light. We thank you, Lord, for your word, which you are going to speak tonight through your servant. Because we know that the word is alive and full of power, making it active, operative, energizing, and effective. And we thank you, Father, O God, that you've given us the opportunity and the privilege to come together once more on this prayer line live, God. Lord, thank you for establishing this prayer line live, God, the prayer line live for the benefits of souls who come on this prayer line every night that we come together on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday. Thank you for sustaining this prayer line live. We respond to your call every night to lift up every need that come to this prayer line live, God. So Lord, oh God, grant us the grace every night when we come together before your presence, that we will have an answer what we have prayed for. Lord, because you promise in your word that if two of us agree on earth concerning anything that we ask, it will be done for us by our Father in heaven. So we give you praise, we give you glory tonight in Jesus' precious, precious holy name. The title of the message again tonight is Spending Time with God Offers Eternal Benefits. Text tonight came from the book of Matthew 24, verse 23. It says here, after he dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, some computer companies offer, if you heard the word, refurbished models of their popular units, usually featured at a retail or online outlet, or even in computer or internet. So these models have, for one reason or another, been returned to the manufacturer, where any necessary repairs have been made. So each one goes back through the production process and undergoes testing before they are released to the buying public at a considerable savings over their brand new counterparts. So even though they are less than new, the units come out after being processed and become like new. So the same happened in spiritual renewal. We bring ourselves back to God to allow him to do his restoration in us. So as a result, we are made new. Hallelujah. Just as the computer manufacturer has the processes and tests for accomplishing the repurposing of his product, so God has his methods of renewing us also. So some of his methods include what? The spiritual disciplines of solitude, of prayer, spending time with him, and also Bible study. So time devoted to each of these can make us new once more. Go to the book of our text tonight, Matthew 14, verse 22. We'll go through that. So when you hear the term discipline, what comes to mind? Perhaps the idea of punishment arises. Discipline may contain a note that, but it goes beyond punitive measures, extending the penalty to include correction and training in doing what is right. Seen in this light, the term goes for beyond standard concept of instruction in penalties. That is why spiritual disciplines include the things you involve yourself in for the purpose of improving the quality of your spiritual life. That's why this message centers on solitude, spending time with God, prayer, and Bible study. Discipline that can influence you deeply in your eternal destiny. You know, they deepen your awareness when you spend time with God and appreciation of who God is. They also open the eyes and the ears of your soul, of your heart, and allow you to hear God more clearly. That's why spiritual discipline provides means of growing nearer and nearer to God. So each of these practices plays a key role in your spiritual renewal and transformation. So if you can go to the book of Matthew now, chapter 14, verse 22 to 23, and together we'll go through Mark chapter 1, verse 35, and the book of Luke, chapter 22, verse 39. I repeat, Matthew 14, verse 22, Mark chapter 1, verse 35, and Luke chapter 22, verse 39. Shut in with God in the secret place. Okay, that's what it says. Gaining new power to run in the race. So every one of us is running in the race. So go the words of an old chorus that encourages the discipline of spending time with God. That's why the greatest commendation for this discipline comes from Jesus, who practiced it regularly. So spending time with God is the life of our Lord Jesus Christ. So after the feeding of the 5,000, remember, he saw the need to send both the crowd and his disciples away. Then he was able to slip away to a mountainside by himself to what? To pray, to spend time with God. So his solitude, his being alone, continued into the evening. Jesus obviously cherish time along with the Father. So in so doing, here we could see in our text that Jesus taught us a very important lesson here. It is the ministry for the Father never replaces time spent with the Father. So in fact, if you allow your Christian activity to rob you of time spent with Christ, your activity will in time become powerless. So you need that. You need spending time with God in order for your ministry to be actively in the power of God. So here, Jesus' solitude never distracted him from ministry. Instead, it empowered him. It enhanced his ministry. That's why in Mark 1, prove this, Jesus arose a great while before dawn and sought a solitary place or mountainside where he could commune with his Father. So every time he would do ministry down the valley, he would just go first to the mountainside, spend time with God. He never goes direct to the ministry without spending time with God. Do we do this? Before you go out to minister to others, you have to spend time with God first in order that your ministry will be divinely successful through the hands of God. So it was not long before the day's demand caught up with him, though, arriving in the form of his disciple who seemed to scold him with the news. Can you imagine this? They're looking for him. He disappeared for a while, but they didn't know that he is spending time with God, with his Father. But the disciple doesn't know. So it seemed that the disciple reprimanded Jesus. Verse 36 and 37, it says, "All men seek for thee." They're looking for you. Where have you been? So any thought that solitude will somehow erode your ability to get important things accomplished vanishes in the next two verses here, verse 38 and 39. So here we could see that Jesus immediately, what happened? Encouraged his disciples to continue with him in ministry that involved preaching and casting out demons. So you lose nothing when you take time or spend time with God. Instead, you only gain. So before you do anything during the day in your ministry, spend time with God first. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all those things that will happen during that day will be accomplished. So Jesus also found strength for difficult times in spending time with God, as his experience in the Garden of Gethsemane illustrate. Remember that. So Jesus and his disciples had come to the place where they frequently go, an olive grove located on the Mount of Olives, Luke 22, verse 39. That's why here, Jesus' first order of business when they reached the place was what? Fellowship? No, prayer. That's the first order of business. They have to pray first. So as his statement in verse 40 of Luke 22 shows, his disciples would find strength to face the grueling test, the hard test that lay ahead. Not only did he commend this to his disciple, but he also found his own private place and engaged in the discipline himself. So God will guide you, will discipline you when you spend time with God. Verse 41. So in the busy world you live in, even now, it is not hard to find reason for not spending time in solitude or spending time with God. Every day presents more than enough activity and demands for most people. So you find yourself wishing you had more hours in the day and more days in the week. But Jesus was busy as well. He worked with a limited amount of time to accomplish all that the Father had dispatched him to do or want him to do during that day. But Jesus always remembered this. Jesus, in spite of the busyness of the day, busyness in the ministry, Jesus always took time, spending time with God alone. So you should do the same. Every time you want to minister to other or do things for the Lord, spend time with God. Spend time with the Father. That's the life of our Lord Jesus Christ. Consider when would be the easiest time to practice spending time with God. This is the thing that we have to prioritize. Next, determine where you can get alone with God, where it is quiet. The discipline of solitude or spending time with God usually will require some sacrifices. You have to sacrifice. When you wake up in the morning, spend time with God before you do anything else, before you go to drink your coffee or donut. That's what I do every morning before I do anything else. Spend time with the Word. Spend time with God. Speak to Him and He will speak back to you. Consider when would be the easiest time to practice spending time with God. You have to make a decision. It's a sacrifice. It's not easy, but it's a must that you must do in order for God to guide you the whole day. You will reap spiritual benefits if you do that every single day. You may even find that you are less sleepy and have more energy as you spend time with God. He will give you energy if you don't have any sleep. But if you have no time for God, you'll be sleepy the whole day. Go to Matthew 6, verse 5 to 13. Matthew 6, verse 5 to 13. You know, spending time with God provides you with an opportunity to engage in yet another Christian disciple. What? Prayer. Jesus encouraged believers, you and me, to engage in prayer every single day. Did you pray today? Did you pray yesterday? It's a must every single day. And time prayer in spending time with God. More than in public. Spend time with God alone. He promised here that the prayer they offer to the disciple prayer they offer in their own private prayer time will find a public answer. So you spend time alone with God, you will find a public answer. Matthew 6, verses 5 to 6. A private personal time of prayer, listen to this, offer you the opportunity to let down your guard and be very open with the Lord. And it also shuts out distraction that can interrupt even the most sincere time of your prayer. That's why spending time with God builds a hedge against hypocrisy, which can easily manifest itself in the act of praying. How tempting it is to pray a wordy, flowery, correct grammar prayer in the public gathering in order to impress those who are listening. Sometimes that has been done, a flowery, wordy prayer in order to impress those who are in the midst of fellowship or listening. So you must remember, however, that regardless of how many people are present, you pray to an audience of one. Who? Jesus. That's why multiplicity of words earns you no favor with God. Remember that. People would pray and will occupy the whole world, but it will have no favor with God according to verse 7. Make your prayer simple, direct. That's why when you observe Jesus, after prayer, he would go to minister people. All the word that he would hear from him is, be healed, be delivered. You don't hear him flowery word. That's why only sincerity of the heart can do that. While you may think repeated words, flowery words, and praises will impress God, no, the truth is that he already knows your need. Before you even pray, he knows it already. Jesus not only instructed believers, you and me, regarding this matter, but he also gave them a model. God gave us a model by which to pattern our prayer. It is referred to as the Lord's Prayer. And everyone knows that if you are a student of the Bible. In actuality, it is only a pattern, an example, not really a prayer. It's the way you pray. It's pattern or an example of how the Lord's disciples are to pray. Like the simple technique he earlier taught in the book of Matthew chapter 6. This prayer displays straightforward simplicity and honesty. Prayer depends on relationship, not the flowery word or many praises. According to verse 9, your relationship with others and your relationship with God matters most than flowery word. Its elements include reverence, submission, and your request. That's why praying like this requires no profound biblical insight. It is truly a pattern. Anyone can follow the Lord's Prayer. Hallelujah. That's why keep in mind, however, that simplicity and sincerity do not exclude spending a lengthy time in prayer. If you are sincere, if you are honest, if you are simple, it doesn't matter if your prayer is very short. Jesus proved this when he spent an entire night praying for the express purpose of choosing his apostle. He prayed all night in order to choose his apostle and his followers. So the decision you face may require you to spend more time in prayer as well. The important thing in the discipline of prayer is not the amount of time you spend at it, but simply that you engage in it, in spending time with God in order to know what you should do. Like the discipline of solitude. If Jesus found prayer necessary, don't treat it as not vital or important before you do anything during the day. Go to Romans chapter 15 verse 4 and 2 Timothy chapter 2. The Bible offers believers a third spiritual discipline here. Okay? While some might see the Bible as an irrelevant book written centuries ago and out of touch with the modern day, it is quite the opposite is true. Though written in the past, it offers relevant, practical, important teaching that encourage and build faith today. Romans 15:4, the Bible has been called a window. What kind of window? A window of hope through which we look into eternity. Every age and every individual needs this window. The Word of God. Go to the Word of God every day and you will see through the window to look into your future with God. So gaining the treasure the Bible offers you, however, requires something deeper than just reading. Paul used the word, study the word. 2 Timothy chapter 2, in order to go deeper in the things of God, you must study the Bible every day to describe the approach needed to make good use of your time. That's why the term speak of diligence, sacrificial effort, rather than just reading the Bible like a newspaper. Further, he described the student of God's word as a workman, implying effort in labor. That's why the profitability of Bible study owes us and know the existing of the nature of God. It is more than historical record and much more than collection of religious writing by people of faith. That's why the entire whole Bible or scripture came by way of divine inspiration. If you're a student of the Bible, you know this fact. So, like spending time with God in prayer, the discipline of Bible study will take effort in time also. But like the other two disciplines, you should not measure it in terms of cost, but rather in worth. Does it worth spending time with God? Does it worth spending reading the Bible? The cost of Bible study, praying, spending time with God pales in comparison to the word it provides, eternal blessing. Hallelujah. So the small, you know, one small match can produce a gigantic fire in a forest. That's why a tiny spark plug can help propel an automobile. Everyone knows that. The addition of one or two spices can drastically change the taste of a food. If you are a cook, you know that. That's why a small thing have a big result. Such is true of the discipline covered in this message tonight. Spending time with God. Bible study may appear to be small things on the surface, so small that they can easily be ignored by a believer. But they hold the power. Spending time with God holds the power to transform you. Like the match, they can ignite the fire. Like the spark plug, they can invigorate Christian service and propel you to a new level of your work with God. Hallelujah. That's why spending time with God or disciplines as this may appear to be a rigorous, hard, and they will each pose difficulties in this fast-paced age. You know, fast food, everything is fast. May involve difficulties in you because you have to put time in your spending time with God. That's why crowded schedule will not readily present time for spending time with God. Instead, you will have to make time for them and honor that time faithfully. every single day of your life. Along with the demands and the occasional difficulty, each of these disciplines provides you with a great reward. And what are the rewards? In spending time with God, you're spending time with the one who created you. Can you imagine you spending time with the one who created you and you open yourself to his influence?
With the prayer online.
Number two, in prayer you commune with him. In Bible study, he will in turn speak to you. As a result, you will find yourself continually renewed and empowered for your daily living with God. That's why spending time with God daily, studying the Word of God daily, will surely prove to be your empowerment of your life here on earth for His glory and for His honor in Jesus. In Jesus' precious holy name, let me just close up in prayer. Lord, we seek you with all our heart tonight. We will always seek you, God, and spend time with you all the days of our life, knowing that we will surely find you when we seek your face continually, daily. When we draw near to you, we know you will draw near to us. You are our God, and early every morning, God, as we seek you, every morning we will seek you all the days of our life. Our soul thirsts for you daily, God. We desire to see your power, your glory, your transforming power. Your loving kindness is better than life, Lord. Therefore, our lips will praise you and will bless you that we may receive your offer of eternal benefits. We thank you, Lord. We talk of all your wonderful things in our life, all the blessing, God. We glory in your holy name as our heart rejoice while we seek you every morning, O God, or spending time with you. You have revealed so many things to us by your Spirit when we spend time with you. And mighty things which we could not know apart from seeking you will arise, will manifest in our lives, Lord. So you are, Lord, we know that you are rewarder of all who diligently seek you and spending time with you daily. Thank you, Lord, tonight. Thank you, O God, for coming to us when we seek you and spend time with you, because we know that the reward is eternal blessing. So tonight we just want to give you all the glory, the praises, and the honor in Jesus. In Jesus' precious holy name, amen. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Bishop Mel, for that word. Tonight's lesson is from Matthew 14, verse 23. Spending time with God offers eternal benefits. We have a few scripture readings there, and if you can go to our website, Glory Tabernacle Prayer Meeting, blogspot.com. You will hear the full message. Hallelujah. We are now in the portion of taking your prayer requests, praise report, even testimonies to all our listeners here and abroad. This is Glory Tabernacle Prayer Line together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry. We are broadcasted globally tonight. We can take all your prayer requests, praise reports, even testimonies now. The line is open for you. Hallelujah. Anybody on the prayer line with a prayer request?
It grows bigger. We can't wear shoes anymore.
Who is this? Hello?
Hello, Pastor Marina.
Oh, hi. This is
Marilyn.
Oh, Marilyn, do you have any prayer requests?
Yes, Pastor. My prayer request is I'm praying that there will be a solution to this problem.
What is that again? I can't hear good.
That my problems will be solved.
What is it about? Is a job?
Yes, it is one of my problems. Yeah, because soon the patients will be brought to the restaurant, and I won't be having a job anymore. And then there are more things about my health, and I don't have health insurance.
Okay.
So I really can't detail all my problems, but I feel like it's really heavy, Pastor Marina. So I'm asking a prayer that God will give a solution.
Okay, hallelujah. You heard the message, right?
Yes.
Okay. Jesus make it a point of taking time to be with his heavenly Father. And this is his priority, and the same should be true for us. So we should never be, there should never be a day that we should fail to open his word and ask him to speak to our hearts through prayer. Hallelujah. Through prayer, he can give us the strength and the hope to endure. So make it a point that you open your Bible, talk to him, listen to what he has to say to you. And also we go on prayer. And right now we will be praying for you, okay? Claire, can you lift her up?
Heavenly Father, we lift up to you Sister Marilyn's prayer request, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that, Lord, as she's going through these problems that are heavy, and, Lord, she don't really know what to do, Lord, give her wisdom, give her direction. Lord, provide for her a job, provide for her health insurance. Anything that she needs, Lord God, let her turn to you. Let her seek your face, and Lord, you will answer her, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for the word that you gave us tonight through Bishop Mel, that, Lord, we need to spend time with you, God. And Lord, the only way that we can have power to go on to minister, to do what you've called us, is to spend quiet time with you, Lord God. I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are, oh my God, you are my strength and my song. And when I'm in your presence, though I'm weak, you're always strong. Help us, Lord, to seek you, Lord, that, Lord, you will give us the strength, you will help us have wisdom, and you will show us the way that we should go, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Okay, Sister Marilyn, I hope you're encouraged. Hallelujah. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request? Hello? Brother Robert, are you on? Do you have any prayer requests? Hello? Sister Marilyn, you heard the prayer?
I heard a prayer. And then I don't know what happened. It stopped. I was listening, and then suddenly it stopped. So I dialed again.
Oh, which one stopped? Our line?
Yeah, I don't know what happened. I was just holding my phone, and it just suddenly stopped. I said, oh, what happened? But it was just seconds, and then I heard the prayer, Pastor Marina, from Sister Claire. Thank you so much, because as of this moment, I feel like it's really heavy, my problem. A lot of things going on. And thank you for all the prayers.
Amen. Try to open your Bible, okay? It will encourage you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Hallelujah. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request?
Oh, God.
May I call on Sister Lila?
Hi, Pastor Marina. Good evening.
Good evening, Sister Lila. Oh, there's a... Can we lift up all our brothers, especially those in the prayer line, and all those who are not here tonight, that God will guide them and protect them wherever they are. Mm-hmm. All right?
Okay, thank you. Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you, Lord, tonight. We are so blessed, Lord, to hear your word, and it's very powerful, Lord God. Thank you for using Bishop Mel to give us the encouraging word, Lord God, from you, dear Father. We thank you, Lord God. We are energized and renewed. Our hope is being renewed and strengthened, Lord. Thank you so much. Tonight, Lord, we would like to pray for our brothers and sisters who are not able to come to the prayer line, Lord, wherever they are and whatever they are doing, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to protect them, give them strength, Lord God, and courage to continue whatever they are doing for your glory, Lord God. We pray for Sister Connie, Lord, who have just moved to Seattle. Lord, we understand that there's a lot of unpacking and getting into order all the things that she brought there, Lord. But we pray for your healing, for your power, Lord, to strengthen her, guide her, and to strengthen also the family, Lord. Bind them with your love and thy protection. We ask you, Lord, to grant Sister Connie, Lord God, whatever she is in her heart, Lord, whatever it pleases you, Lord God, for your glory and for your honor. Lord, we pray for Sister Edessa and Brother Robert, Lord. Protect them, Lord. Bind them with your love. Strengthen their marriage, Lord God. And please use them, Lord, mightily for spreading your word, Lord God. And also protect them, Lord, and give them more encouragement to continue, Lord, in attending the Bible school, Lord God. We pray that whatever is asked by Sister Edessa from you with regards to her documentation, Lord, please have mercy upon her, and may it be a success, Lord God, for whatever she's aspiring for, Lord God. Please give her the job that is really for her, Lord God, that a job that she will fulfill her duty, Lord, to be used, Lord God. Strengthen her mightily, Lord, wherever she's coming through and going through, and may your light shine upon her, Lord, and both of them. Lord God, we pray for our sister Chief, her ministry, Lord, in the Philippines, and here, her nursing home ministry. We pray for his family, Lord God. Thank you for strengthening them, using them, Lord, mightily. And we pray that your everything, Lord God, will be according to your will. We are so blessed, Lord God, for your faithfulness to them. We pray also for Sister Merle, Lord God, wherever she is, Lord. We ask the same prayer, Lord, to strengthen her and give her more courage to be one that is a fulfilling and rewarding for your rewarding job, Lord God, for your glory and for your honor. And everything that I did not mention, Lord, you know who they are. And all the silent listeners, Lord, please bless them tonight, Lord God. Hear the cry of their heart, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Lai.
God bless.
God bless you. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request or praise report? Brother Robert, are you on? Brother Robert, are you on? Hello? Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request? Marilyn, you want to pray or you want to sing tonight?
I can't sing, Pastor Marina. I don't know a song.
Okay, you wanna.
Ano yan, ambulance?
I think so, yeah. Hallelujah. Pray for our nation. Pray for Philippines and America. Okay.
Sino po, Pastor Marina?
Ikaw. Do you want to pray for the Philippines and America?
Hindi po ako marunong masyadong mag-English eh.
Simple lang. Just whatever is in your heart. Pasalamat. English. Salamat. Thank you. Na nakatira ka dito. Okay? Go ahead.
Lord God Father, thank you for all the blessings. Thank you for
Hallelujah. Whatever God did to you.
Oh God, I can't say a Pastor Marina.
Okay, Sister Claire, can you help her?
What do you want?
Pray for that she will be able to communicate with the Lord through the Bible, through prayers, to help her be encouraged, so that as we go through storms of life, she will be strong, she can stand firm, and she'll be encouraged to go on. Okay? Go ahead.
Heavenly Father, we lift up Sister Marilyn to you, Lord God. When she finds herself in a time of trial, Lord God, you are the one, Lord God, who's with her right now, Lord God. And what's happening to her, Lord God, you see everything, Lord God. You know what's taking place now, and you know what the end result will be, Lord God. Lord, you're refining her as gold in the fire, Lord God. Help her to trust you, Lord God. Help her to look to you, Lord God, that, Lord, you will strengthen her. You will give her patience, endurance, everything she needs, Lord, to get through what she's going through, Lord God. Lord, let her have confidence, trust in you, Lord, that you will see her through, Lord God. And she's never alone, Lord God. Lord God, you are the one with her, Lord. And Lord, blessed is the one who trusts in you, Lord God, that keep his testimonies and who seek, inquire of him and hunger and thirst for the Lord, Lord God. Lord, let her seek you while she can find you, Lord, and you will be there for her. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Okay, Sister Marlene, be encouraged.
Thank you, Sister Marlene.
Hallelujah. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request or a praise report? Anybody else?
Sister Marina.
Oh, hi, Sister Ella.
I just want to praise God for his faithfulness, because every day that I wake up in the morning, I really cannot stand. All my knees are locked up. It's really hard. It's like I have no strength to stand at all. So the 1 hour of walking now is becoming 2 hours, but I pray, I continually pray, and I have a new hope that he will bring me home to safety, and he will bring me back to work the next day. So I praise God for His faithfulness. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Lila.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else with a praise report or a testimony or a prayer request? Sister Lila, can you sing for us tonight?
Okay. If we can sing together, I am thine, O Lord. So we are thine, O Lord. We are thine, O Lord. We have heard thy voice, and it told thy love to us. But we long to rise in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to thee. Draw us nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where those died. Draw us nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Consecrate us now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. Let our soul look up with a steadfast hope, and we'll be Lord in thine. Draw us nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw us nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Thank you, Jesus, for drawing us nearer to you. Dear Father, thank you for drawing us closer to Jesus every day. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Lai.
Mm-hmm. Welcome.
May we call on our evangelist for some encouragement tonight?
Amen and amen. God's still
amen.
On the throne.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hello, Pastor Marina. God is still on the throne. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yes.
Yes, he hasn't got off the throne. He's still in charge if we let him. That's the thing. That's the thing. If we let him. You know, I praise God for Glory Tabernacle Ministries. You know, I praise God for you guys, and I thank you guys so much for everything you're doing for the kingdom of God and for this ministry of Consuming Fire Radio and everything. You guys are a blessing in Jesus' name. I tell you, it's just awesome what God is doing, and I thank God every day for you guys. But I'm going to tell you something. I'm getting out on the limb here. I want Sister Lila right now, if she's here. Can you hear me, Sister Lila?
Oh, Jesus.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Okay.
Evangelist Mike, I have all the materials, but
no, listen, this is what I want you to do. This is what I want you to do. I want you to get your both hands and put them on your knees right now. Okay, you ready? In the name of Jesus, I command the healing power of God to come in right now from the top of her head to the soles of her feet, right to her knees right now, and do a creative miracle healing in the name of Jesus on her knees right now. By Jesus' stripes, she was healed 2,000 years ago, and we're having a manifestation healing right now of the power of God right now. The power of God is flowing through her right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, I want you to start walking around that room right now. I want you to start walking around the room right now, sis. Can you do that for me?
Around, Layla.
Oh, praise you, Jesus. You're totally healed. Reach out and grab that gift of healing. I just got, the glory bumps are all over me. Hallelujah. You're totally healed, sis. Because of your faithfulness to him, because you're spending time with him, as the bishop has given the message this evening, you have reaped the benefits of the healing this evening. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. So you keep that. Don't let the enemy take it away from you, okay?
Yes, Evangelist Mike, thank you for your prayers.
Yes, hallelujah. You are healed, sis. You are totally healed because you've spent time with the King. You put him number one. See, this is what we've got to do, folks. Okay, see, you shouldn't have gave me the mic. I'm going to cut it loose now. Yeah. Only thing I can say, folks, spend time with him that created you. Don't put him last. Don't put him before Walmart. Don't put him before your job. You put him number one, yeah, because he's the one that created you. Because he's the one that knew you before you were even created. Okay, if that makes sense. That's like a metaphor. But he knew you before you were in your mother's womb. Okay, folks? He knew you. He created you, each and every one of us. God is on the throne, and Evangelist Mike Bradford needs to chill out. He needs to chill out. I'm preaching to myself happy here. He needs to chill out and let God be God. That's all I got.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Evangelist Mike.
You're welcome. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You're healed, sis. I want you to start walking around. I want you to walk around that room before this is prayer meeting's over with. I want you to give a praise report. Okay?
I walk around and my knees are lighter.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank God.
No, don't thank me. You thank him. He's the one that did it.
It's lighter now. Even my back pain.
Amen. Come on.
Amen.
It's going to get easier. Yeah.
While you're praying for Sister Lila, I put my hands on my knees too. And
did you get some?
Good.
Yeah, I'm glad you got some of it. Yes, right now in the name of Jesus, let the fire of God come on the Malto house right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Let the fire of God fall upon the man of God and the woman of God and the evangelist of God right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let the fire of God fall upon the Malto house right now, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We receive it.
Yes.
We receive it.
Yes, hallelujah. I'm getting fired. You got me fired up now. Okay.
We love that fire.
Yeah, I love it too. I'm a pyromaniac for the Lord. Starting fires everywhere.
Amen.
Okay,
thank
I'm going to let you go.
Thank you. Randy,
I'm on mute.
God bless.
God bless.
God
I'm bless on mute.
You.
Hey, Colin, Sister Cynthia.
Yes.
Hi, Sister
Marina. Yeah, praise the Lord. I'm not at home. I'm on the street.
Oh.
I don't know. I'm on the street.
Oh, you're on
Rock
the street.
Yes.
You hear everything, right?
Yes,
we're
I hear everything.
We're on fire right now.
The God be the glory.
Thank
the
you, Jesus. Yes. So, Sister Lai, can you sing again? Thanks for Thanksgiving. Where we go. Sister Lai, can you hear me? What happened?
Thank you.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, Lord, for the trials that come my way. In that way I can grow each day as I let you lead. Thank you, Lord, But I thank you, Lord God, for your leading into my life, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the healing power that you're giving me. Every time they prayed upon me, Lord, I can feel the difference, Lord God. Forgive me, Lord, for not obeying you, because I am always tempted to carry things that are heavy, which is against the pressure of my knees, Lord God. So please help me to obey and to follow, Lord God, and whatever is not pleasing to you, Lord God, because you already healed me, Lord God. Please give me strength to avoid this, all the unworthy things, Lord, that I'm doing to my body. In Jesus' name, I pray. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, Sister Claire, can we hear another song from you and
group? There is a fountain. Who is the King? Victorious warrior and Lord of everything. My rock, my shelter, my very own. Blessed Redeemer who reigns upon the throne. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, that you're our rock, you're our shelter, you're everything to us, oh God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, Lord, for your presence and your goodness in the lives of your people. Amen.
Amen, amen. Hallelujah. Father God, we pray and confess your word over the body of Christ, your people, Lord, especially in this prayer line. We pray that your people be filled with clear knowledge of your will in all spiritual things, Lord God. And Lord, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for all the encouragement, especially words from Evangelist Mike and everyone else, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for your keeping power, Lord God. Thank you for your presence in this prayer line. Thank you that you hear all our prayers, all our cries, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, that you are always there for us, Lord God. You are always there, Jehovah Shammah, Lord God. And your people, Lord, the chosen ones who are purified and holy and well-beloved by you, give you thanks. Give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Tonight, Lord God. Be with them, Lord, as we close this prayer line tonight. Abide with them. Bless them, Lord, and let your healing power flow through those who are infirm tonight, Lord God. Let your guiding light be with them, Lord God. And let everyone in this prayer line be strengthened in your love, Lord. We give you all the praise and the glory tonight. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Thank you, everyone. And on behalf of Glory Tabernacle Healing and Deliverance Prayer Line, together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry, we bid you good night. God bless you all. And until we meet again next week,
Have a blessed weekend. Let's worship the Lord.